Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and thank you so much for watching. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I made this tropical flamingo pineapple themed cake, so let's get right into it. I'm starting out with 3 6-inch cakes that I've leveled. One of them is blue just because I had an extra one, so don't even worry about it. If yours isn't blue, you can do whatever kind of cake you want for this. Using my small offset spatula, I'm grabbing some Swiss meringue buttercream and using that to fill my cake, just making sure that each layer is nice and even. Once it's stacked up, I'm applying a thin layer of that buttercream all around the outside of my cake to lock in all the crumbs, and then that's going to go in the fridge for about 25 minutes to chill. Once you can touch your finger to the buttercream and none of it comes off, it's ready for the final ice, so I'm adding a big dollop of that buttercream on top and then just going around with my offset spatula and smoothing that out. With my larger spatula, I'm going around the sides of my cake, and then with my bench scraper, I'm going to scrape that back until it's smooth. And for all of the buttercream that accumulated on the top of my cake, I'm just going to pull that into the center. That's going back in the fridge to chill, and in the meantime, I'm going to start on my fondant. I have some white here that I'm rolling out on my cornstarch surface to about 1/8 of an inch thick. Using my fondant roller, I'm picking that up and draping it over my chilled cake, and then just working quickly with my hands and my fondant smoother, I'm getting all the air out from the top of my cake, and then working down, pulling out all the little pleats in the fondant and smoothing until I reach the bottom. I went over the whole thing one more time with my fondant smoother and then cut away the excess using a pizza cutter. Since my cake is 2 tiers, I need to add some support. So I have some bubble tea straws that I'm spacing out evenly into that bottom tier and then marking off where I need to cut. Since my cake was tall, the straws kind of unfurled as I pulled them out, but once I cut them and pressed them back in place, they were flush with the top of the cake, so it was totally fine. I added a little smear of buttercream and then popped on a 4-inch top. I just iced it and covered it in fondant the exact same way I did the bottom tier. On to the decorating. I mixed some teal food coloring gel by Wilton with some food grade alcohol and then started to stipple that on the bottom of my top tier, pretty heavy handed. And then I just worked my way up, kind of diluting the color as I went so that there was an ombre effect. For the bottom tier, I created 2 templates of some tropical leaves as well as 2 templates for some flowers. I rolled out some light green fondant and then cut out a bunch of my leaves, not forgetting to use my fondant tool to just add that vein that runs to the center of each leaf. I did the same thing for my flowers using some yellow fondant and then used my fondant tool to separate each of the petals, and with my X-Acto knife I scored in a bunch of lines just to give each flower a little more texture. I used some shortening to attach my leaves and my flowers to the bottom tier, and I just spaced them out however I thought looked good. Mixing some dark green food coloring gel with some food grade alcohol, I stippled that on to each of my leaves, still making sure that you could see the lighter green coming through underneath that. With some pink food coloring gel, I did the flowers as well, just concentrating the color in the center, and then just like the gradient effect on the top tier, I just used a little bit of a lighter hand as I worked my way towards the edge of each petal. For the center of each flower, I need to add the stamen and the pistil. Not really up to snuff with my flower anatomy, but I think that's right. So I took some yellow and then rolled it out into this long tapered off snaky shape and added that right into the center, and then rolled out a couple small balls of yellow fondant and then put those towards the very end. To make my flamingo for the top tier, I have some pink fondant and I'm rolling it out into this teardrop shape and then really rolling out one end of it, trying to make sure that the very end of that piece stays kind of like a ball. Hopefully that made a little bit of sense, and just watching me do it will help you. I will link the picture that I used for inspiration, but I basically just shaped this into a flamingo-y shape using my fingers and my fondant tool. I used some white fondant to create his beak, and then I rolled out a little piece of black fondant and just draped that over the front, and then just trimmed off the sides. I made a little teeny tiny crescent moon shape for the eye, and for the wing, I used some lighter pink fondant, created a teardrop shape that I rolled down against my work surface, and with my X-Acto knife, I just cut in some wings and then shaped them a little bit more with my fingers. I placed my flamingo on the front of my cake. I used a little bit of water and adhered just fine, but if you're not sure if it's going to be stable enough, you could always add in a couple pieces of spaghetti just to keep it nice and snugly in place. Using the same color pink I used for the body, I rolled out a long rope and then just added that underneath for the leg. To make my pineapple, I have this template. If you watch my channel at all regularly, you know that I use templates for everything, and I will link this one below as well. I cut that out using some yellow fondant, and then with my fondant tool, I just marked in where all of the lines and the crisscrosses go onto the fondant, and then just indented those so that they were pretty deep. I want to make sure the squares stand out as much as possible. I flipped my pineapple over, and then with a strip of yellow fondant and two spaghetti pieces, I'm just attaching that onto the back with a little bit of water, and that's going to make it so my pineapple will be able to be inserted into my cake. I brushed the front with some shortening, making sure that I covered the whole thing, and then sprinkled that with some gold disco dust. Being really careful not to touch the glitter so it doesn't get everywhere, I just inserted that into the top of my cake. The very last thing I did is cut out some strips of white and my pink fondant, and then I rolled those up so they look like itty bitty roses, and then added a little floral crown to the top of my flamingo's head. I lied! The very, very last thing I did is add a little bit of almond flour to the bottom to make it look like sand. You could also use brown sugar if you don't have the almond flour. I just like that it's a little bit lighter. And this was the final result, guys. I hope you liked this cake. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you did. I think it turned out so pretty, and I'm so pleased with it. Don't forget to subscribe for new videos every week. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.